On today's video, I thought I'd talk about mobile editing. Not mobile editing on a laptop, but mobile editing on a mobile device. Not too long ago, only 3 or 4 years, I remember thinking to myself, why can I not edit video on my Android device? I just wanted to take like a 2-minute long clip and cut it down to 45 seconds so that I could send it in a text message. It baffled me that I could not do this. iOS had iMovie that kind of gave that functionality. Why couldn't Android do it? Fast forward a couple years, and now we have Adobe Premiere Clip. I'd never used it before, and I got to thinking, I wonder what this is capable of, because I use Adobe Premiere when I'm editing these videos. Could I make a video that was quality enough that I'd feel comfortable posting it on the internet on YouTube? The scenario I set out for myself was thinking, okay, I'm backpacking through Europe, and I want to carry as light a stuff as possible. I don't want to carry around my 3-pound or 5-pound or even 7-pound laptop. I want to just carry my mobile device and my iPad. Could I, throughout the day taking pictures and videos of the historic sites, at night go back to a fire with a beer and sit down and make a video to make it so I could share it at night on YouTube? Not being in Europe right now, I worked within the parameters I had available to me. I decided to go out to the 4 main parks in my hometown and try and recreate the type of day you might have walking around seeing sights in Europe. I went out and used nothing but my Google Pixel XL phone and my iPad Pro 10-inch to shoot all the videos and pictures. Once I had a fair bit of material, I went back home and decided to try to copy onto a USB flash drive because I was hoping maybe I could just work off of that as kind of a backup. Now, I have one of these USB micro USB devices. Well, unfortunately, this is now old enough that neither of these devices actually supports this. So I had to get out
the dongles.
Got a USB-C one for my Android and a photo lightning connector for my iPad. Copying off of the Android onto the flash drive was no problem at all. iPad, however, demonstrated again why iOS is not my favorite thing to work with. No matter what I did, I could not get the pictures and videos to copy onto the flash drive. I could copy off of the flash drive, no problem. I really wanted to copy the photos off of the iPad onto the USB drive because I wanted to use my Android device to do the editing because I wanted to try it on as small a screen as possible. I was just beginning to think I was going to have to upload everything off my iPad and then re-download it to my phone or use something like Bluetooth transfer because remember, I was working without a laptop. When I decided, let's see what USB-C can do because it has continually surprised me what it is capable of when I start plugging things into my phone. So I plugged the iPad into the phone and sure enough, the iPad showed up as a camera device and I was able to just browse it as if I was on a computer and copy all the files over that way. So now I had all the files stored onto my Android, and just for good measure, I copied them back out to my flash drive. So now I was ready to settle back and try out Adobe Premiere Clip. Now, I like to really tweak my videos quite a bit. I like to do the color correction and video stabilizing and things that kind of just take a little bit of processing time. And I was really curious to see how my phone would be able to handle this. Well, I got going, and after walking through the surprisingly helpful tutorial, I realized that this was pretty bare bones. It let me edit the videos, edit the length, put the pictures in, stuff like that, but in terms of actual editing beyond, about the only thing that was available was color correction, brightness, and filters. So I continued working with what they gave me, knowing that I had very shaky video from trying to do pan shots holding an iPad. But surprisingly, it was actually very easy to get the videos and pictures in the order I wanted. I just kind of broke it up into parks, did one park, one park, one park, one park, and then went through and did color correction on all of it. And along the way, I kept seeing the little syncing icon show up. So I was thinking, okay, we're just backing all this up to my Creative Cloud Drive. That's fine. I don't have a whole lot of space, so we'll delete it when I'm done. I continued going on and got everything just the way I wanted it. And then I thought, okay, now it's time for audio. My audio was horrible. I wasn't really planning to use any of the audio. There's cars driving by, there's kids talking. It was just kind of a mess. So I went into the audio settings and started looking, and I saw they had a few royalty-free options available. I listened to them and none of them really struck my fancy. So I decided just to download an audio song that I made using GarageBand 5 or 6 years ago. That's when I ran into problem number two. You can only put one audio clip in there. It can loop until it's done, but you can't line up this song, this song, this song. And so in my final video, you're going to see that it plays through my song, repeats, and then repeats again and cuts itself off at the end because there's no audio length editing. You can choose when it starts in all of your videos, but you cannot choose when the song starts, if you get my drift, like when it repeats, stuff like that. Now I had the video clips cut, color corrected as best I could, and I had audio running. The only thing left to do was to render it out and export it. Adobe Premiere Clip has the ability to export directly to YouTube or to Creative Cloud, but I decided just to export it to my phone. I plugged it in and watched it go. It took about 30 to 45 minutes to process the 6 to 7 minute video, which isn't that bad. But when it got all done, I pulled it up on my computer and watched it. And yes, it's been edited and color corrected, but it has had a lot of compression done to it. I shot everything in 4K, hoping I could edit in 4K, which I know is a big pipe dream, but you know, I just wanted to see what was available. Well, my only options were 720 or 1080p. So I picked 1080, and it really looks like it's kind of gone through the internet compression scheme 4 or 5 times in some parts. But it still was an edited video using nothing but mobile. Now, Adobe Creative Cloud has the ability to sync across devices. So I saw that, like I said, my video was uploading this whole time. I thought, well, let's see if the iPad has anything different. So I pulled that up and saw that it was trying to download stuff. Well, it didn't download my edits. It downloaded the original file that I uploaded. So it had none of the time duration changes, it had none of the position changes, it had none of the color correction that I spent hours doing. I did enjoy the editing process on the mobile device using the touchscreen. It's very convenient to just drag the pictures and videos to whatever order I wanted using my finger, and then to go in there and adjust the timeline. I almost found it more enjoyable than using a mouse because I could just sit back and relax. But there was that horrible compression. So I saw that Adobe Premiere Clip had an export to Adobe Premiere Pro option. So I clicked that and was promptly displayed with a warning error message saying, this is not possible, you must wait for it to finish syncing. So I went back to the iPad to see if it had synced. Nope, still the same files. I went back to the Android, clicked on the syncing, it said 58%, then it said complete. Back, forth, try, 58%, nothing. I don't know where this file is. Turns out, somehow, because I had made a copy to back up stuff before I started going and then renamed the copy, Adobe Creative Cloud got confused and only had the original files, none of my edits. So no matter what I did, I could not export to Adobe Premiere. I could not export to another device. So I was stuck using just my phone and what it could render out. The big question is, do I think this is an adequate method for editing video? Yes, if you really want to push it. While I was able to cut the clips to the length I wanted and do some nice photo zooms that were automatically in there, I could even put title text at the beginning and a watermark, bonus points for that. The quality at the end of the day was not something that I'd want to remember for my trip to Europe. I would definitely maybe save it for the quick edits to show on a vlog or to your family or whatever, like here's what I did, but then make sure that I export it to Premiere Pro so it's waiting for me when I get back home so I can do a master video and upload it as a really good feature. But it's not a production level program yet. Bonus story time. I did end up uploading that video to YouTube, and you can check it out here or here, whichever side it's on. I uploaded it to private while I was waiting to finish this video. And after a day, I got a copyright infringement saying that I'd used someone else's song. Now remember when I said I made a song on GarageBand 5 or 6 years ago? The last date I have for it is 2012. Well, it turns out this other company had used the same samples in their song, and YouTube had matched them up based on that. It had to have been YouTube because it's a private video, unless they're allowing record companies to source through all videos. So I had to file a dispute. Now the good thing is I had a source file for it, so I'm not too worried about it. I'm still waiting to hear back from it. But that's my advice for this video, is make sure you always hang on to your source files, pre-render, pre-watermark, whatever, so that way you can guarantee that you did make the content and not this other company. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a little bit about what's available for video editing on mobile devices. Hit a like if you want to see a speed competition between an iPad Pro, an NVIDIA Shield tablet, and a Google Pixel XL in a rendering Adobe Clip Premiere Battle Royale. After you're done with that, I'd really appreciate it if you'd subscribe, and then check out one of our other videos right over here. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.